Hello everyone, myself is Shubhalakshmi Chakraborty. I am the faculty of Computer Science and Engineering Department, UEM Kolkata. Today our course name we selected as Computer Organization and Architecture. Now today we will be doing the first lecture of Computer Organization and Architecture. In this course we will be learning what do we mean by computer organization, as well as what do we mean by computer architecture, and what are the intricacies of this two things. Now let's talk about the fundamentals of the subject. Now from the name itself, there are three things we can see from the name, like what is computer, what is computer organization, and what is computer architecture. Now everywhere nowadays we find computer. Whether it is healthcare sector, whether it is education sector, whether it is any kind of public or private sector, we find the computers everywhere. Now, technically, computer means it's a, what can I say, it's an electronic and electromechanical device which is capable of performing multiple tasks. Okay? And it is also having a capability of storing huge amount of data also. Right. So, what is the requirement of computer? Previously, many of us have seen that to write a simple letter or to write any kind of documentation, we should have used the typewriters. Nowadays, we all use computers. Now, what was the disadvantage of the typewriter? Now, suppose if you are doing something erroneous, it is very difficult to remove the error from the letter. So you need to discard the paper. Nowadays you are using Microsoft Word or Microsoft Excel to write one letter in Microsoft Word or to do some calculations in the Microsoft Excel. So if you want to modify the document, you can easily modify it. So everywhere, even in the simplest thing also, we are getting the advantage of computer. So there is no way of denying that without computer our life is becoming, will become a standstill one. Now what do you mean by computer architecture? Computer architecture basically deals with the how the components of the computer is made of, like we have the hardware components, how it is connected and all these things. And like what can I say, the example can be how the instruction set, instruction format, instruction addressing mode, or how the peripherals are connected. All the things belong to computer architecture. Okay, that is it refers to the parameters which is visible by the user end. Okay. Now, what about the computer organization? Computer organization basically deals how the things are getting organized within the architecture, or to realize the architecture, how the things are getting organized within a computer. We will be doing all these things. We will be learning all these things while the course is getting the progress. So, let us take the computer architecture part. It deals, what I told, it deals basically the conceptual design and the basic overview of a computer. And computer organization is basically how the constituent parts are interconnected and how it interoperate to realize the architectural requirement. Okay. There are four characteristics basically which a computer should have. There are four things. Number one is the speed, second is the accuracy, third is the storage, and fourth is the decision making. Okay. Now, what do you mean by speed? It means the speed of the processor. Now, if you want to go to buy a computer, you prefer the computer which is having a higher speed, right? There are different types of processors available, you know, right? you have this Pentium series, you have i3, i7. So as a buyer perspective, the speed requirement is very, very important, as the machine is capable of doing multiple operations so quickly, right? Second is accuracy. Accuracy means how efficiently or accurately the computer is going to perform the task. Okay. Now, the third one is the storage. Storage means it is capable of storing the huge amount of information, whether it is the internal storage or external storage. It is the capability how it is going to store the informations. And last is the decision making. So, it is another capability of the computer to decide something depending on the input of the certain input, you can say. Now, digital computer. Nowadays, all of us using the digital computers. Previously, analog computers were used, and we have given the analog signal as the input there. But nowadays, digital computers are used, and one digit is nothing but the bit. So, the data or informations are stored in form of binary digit, or that is known as bit. Now, a group of bit will constitute one byte, and I have not mentioned here, a group of 8 bits will constitute one byte, and a group of 4 bit will constitute one nimble. Okay. Now, these are the things, because we will be learning all these things in later chapters. Next, the languages used by the computers are mainly of 3 types. Number 1 is the high level language, number 2 is the assembly language, and third one is the machine level language. Now, high level language is a language basically used by the application level software, right? They have whatever we do, that is in form of we are writing a letter or we are writing, doing some calculations, whatever from the user end, those are written in the high level language. But the computer doesn't understand the language, right? So, we need to convert, or some machinery is, or some platform is needed to convert the high level language to the machine understandable low level language. Okay, and that is done by the compiler. I will come to that later. Now, come to the components of a computer. There are basically 3 components of a computer. First one is the hardware, second is the software, and third one is the human resource. Hardware means you have the memory, you have the CPU, which is constituted by the ALU, CU, registers, cache memories, all these things, right? And you have the other input output peripherals. Within software, what we can say? Within software, we have 2 things. Number 1 is the system software, number 2 is the application software. Now, software is nothing but a collection of program which is capable of doing a particular task, okay, or you can say collection of instructions. And collection of instruction is nothing but the collection of program. Now, what do you mean by application software? Application software is a program, or you can say a collection of program, which is capable of solving some particular application oriented problem. It is specific to the problem which is there. Okay. And what do you mean by system software? System software basically controls everything. It is supervised all the softwares. In a single word, what can I say? Third one is the human resource. So, human resource is basically a resource which is basically dealing with both the hardwares and softwares. Okay. Now, see this one. This is the block diagram of the computer. which consists of the input, output. This is the central processing unit and the storage. Okay, and within the storage you have the primary storage and the secondary storage. Okay, and within the central processing unit you have the ALU and control unit. Right, and this solid line defines the data flow and the dotted line defines the control flow. So control flow is basically controlling operation is basically done by the central processing unit. Okay, and this picture depicts the hardware software programmer interface. So this is what I was talking about, the human resource. The programmer is nothing but the human resource. Okay, so it is going to supervise both the hardware and the software, and whatever the software changes it is going to do, that is going to ultimately instruct the hardware to do the necessary action. Okay, and that is results is again obtained by the programmer. So if it want to alter some results, it definitely going to change the software, so that the software is going to change the necessary instruction and it will get the result as per its requirement. Okay, so this is all about the thing. Next class we will be talking about the layers of computer. Okay, so thank you.